All right, what is up? If you guys are new here, give us a subscribe and like the video and leave a comment. Let me know what you think. And for everyone else wondering, I know I've gotten a few comments about it. I'm getting back on making another bus video. Basically just waiting on to make some extra money because I got some sheet metal that needs to go in it, but there's a few more pieces I haven't bought yet that need to go in first before those other ones do. So once I gather up some extra money, which is hopefully here soon, I can get some extra parts ordered and get on making another video on this thing. And also I'll probably do a video on another one of my Beetles that I have, because I gotta do some maintenance on it to get it ready for spring. But anyway, quit rambling on, we'll get on with the video. So here we go. All right, what's up guys, back for episode number 2 of the roll cage install. So I'll go ahead and show you where we're starting here. So on this, getting this hoop welded in, we had a Chevelle Ranch comment on there and left some really good information on good ways to weld this and how to do your outriggers and whatnot. I think the more we've looked and the more we've done, I think we're pretty much going to leave it the way we are. We were going to change it and kind of go off of what he said, but heck, we've even looked up some NHRA spec rules, and we could have actually welded this cage right to the floor with that eighth inch plate and been within cert, but this car isn't meant to be a drag car. It's going to be a street car. We're kind of doing this cage more for looks anyways. But if you guys are looking for some good info, go look at his comment in the last video in the comment section, and then I can include a picture of those NHRA spec rules if you guys are interested. I'm going to go ahead and make a little access hole in the top of the floor because I don't really feel like, I don't want to drop the cage down below because I don't have any other material to help keep it from flexing when I weld it. I don't want to be able to try to, I won't be able to spread it if it moves to get it back around the frame. So we're already going to be welding the plate to the floor anyway. So I'm just going to cut some little access holes so I can weld that main hoop to it. And then I can sandwich our floor plate to that and weld it fully all the way around that 6x6 square, and then also weld it around the roll bar, and then it'll be welded to the outrigger, and the outrigger will be welded to the frame and gusseted as well, and we'll show you guys when we make the gussets as well. So I'm gonna go ahead and get these things cut out, and we'll take you along and show you how we're doing it, and go from there. Okay, so we went ahead and tossed the main hoop back in. So there, we got it sitting back in there, and I got this clamp just to keep it from falling backwards. So we have to, first and foremost, before we do anything down here, the directions from the S&W that come with the actual cage itself say you need to weld this harness bar in first. So we're gonna get it where we want it. We are going to drop it down from where we initially had it. As you can see, our new marks, it's about close to even with the door there. And something you got to take into consideration, it looked really high because of these seats, but these seats are super tiny. So also, I'm just going to tack it. I'm not like fully welding it. So basically, I'm going to get it in there, tack it in a couple spots on each side, and then let it cool. That way, it doesn't want to move around a bunch on me. And then I can pull it back out, and we can start addressing everything down here for the outriggers. We got the shop supervisor on in the house, so we gotta make sure to, he's too chonky to even scratch himself. Oh, here we go. He's our indoor outdoor kitty, Bobby C. Whenever shop supervision's around, we gotta make sure to stay busy. As you can tell, he likes to stay busy himself. All right, see you later, Bob. All right. So we're getting some stuff covered up in here. I don't want any of the welding sparks to get on the seats or the windows, so I'm going to go ahead and get that stuff prepped and ready, and then we're going to start fitting this harness bar so we can get it tacked in. Got this thing tacked in place. Gaps are good on it. It's nice and level. Everything fits good. I covered up the glass and the seats on each side when I tacked it in so we didn't hurt any of that nice glass. So, and then I'll obviously clean these up when I go to finish weld it. You know, I'll obviously
get the coating off there, but I didn't, just to get it tacked in. So we got that thing in. Now we're gonna pop it back out so we can start addressing the floors to be able to get in there and weld to the outriggers. So we'll go ahead and pop this thing back out and go from there. Guys, got it out here, letting it cool down. Dad's in there working on the floor, getting it ready so we can set this thing back down in there and get it squared up where we want it, and tack all that stuff in place. And then I'm not a professional welder by any means, but they turned out pretty decent. Pretty happy with them. And obviously we'll be painting all this when we, after we get everything all in. So letting that thing cool down, and after he's done with that, we'll start refitting it. All right, guys, we got it sitting in exactly where we wanted it. Got our access holes made, got it tacked in place. And after we get this thing fully welded, and then get the outrigger fully welded, we'll cut a hole in our plate pieces, slip those around it, fully welded around the floor, and fully welded around it there. So it'll not only be braced with the eighth inch plate, but it'll be welded around the eighth inch plate there, and fully around the floor, and fully around the outrigger. And we'll do that on both sides. So we'll go ahead and get that going, and take you along for the ride. All right, showed you guys that we had it sitting in there and had it tacked in place. We were super happy with it, so we went ahead and finished it out. So as you can see from the side, can't see it, and I just got the down bar laying in there. We were kind of playing with it, seeing how much we're gonna have to cut off it, but that'll be for a later time. But anyway, got her all finished up. Pretty happy with it. And there's the other side. Hard to get in here, being these seats don't move, but turned out pretty dang good.
And then, like I was saying, I'll have to put the picture, hopefully I'll do it after this clip, but the NHRA spec sheet we were looking at for these main hoops for, I think it's for like an 11 and a half second cert when you have to have a cage. You can actually just weld an eighth inch plate directly to the floor and weld these bars directly to the floor and it even counts. So what we're doing is going to be way stronger. Got the outriggers all burned in to the frame, got it burned in here. And then I got the plate ready. My dad got these all marked where they're going to be and where exactly they go. So I will drill those out and cut them and get them sandwiched in here, weld them fully around the outside, and then obviously down the seam and all the way around the bar as well. And then after I do that, I'll film some of that tomorrow. And then we'll be working on getting these down bars going. But it turned out pretty nice. Super good fitment up here, as you can tell. Hard to see, but pretty happy with it. So now I'll move on and we'll do those plates and get those welded in. I'll show you those when we're finished up. Might even film me welding them in and we'll go from there. All right, we're back. It's the next day. I went ahead and got me my 1¾-inch hole saw. And we should be ready to go ahead and mark the center of these bad boys and get to drilling. All right, we're gonna go ahead and get the centers all marked up. Sharpie and nice straight edge, which for me is a nice little machinist ruler. Things drilled out. All right, got our holes cleaned up. I got them both drilled, obviously. I got my center line marked, so go ahead and get these things split so we can get them inside the car and weld them in. All right. Dad did a killer job getting these marked up. Beautiful fit. So go ahead and get the floor cleaned up and bevel the edges where I just cut them and get a little video of me welding these bad boys in. All right, guys. Got them both in, cleaned up and fitting good. And had a dumbass attack and I accidentally cut this one this away and the other one that away. Not that it matters, but just kind of bugs my OCD, but doesn't matter, nothing I can do now. They fit perfect and I'm gonna weld them in. They'll get painted and covered up anyway. So let's go ahead and clean up the cage. went through, let this thing cool down, and got the wire wheel out, cleaned everything up on both sides, as well as the around the harness bar there, and did the other side as well. So we'll go check this out real quick. Got it all cleaned up. So now we are officially ready to start on those down bars. All right, guys, it's gonna do it for video number two on roll cage installation. And like I said, I'm not a professional cage builder, maker, nor am I hardly professional at all, but hopefully this helps on anyone that wants to try installing one of these pre-made kits and their Tri-5. It's pretty simple. Like I said, we're going for more look than function, but it should be pretty daggone strong the way it is. So I hope this helps people out and not be so scared to get into it. But if you're really, really looking for more certifications and more for going fast and being a true drag car, I would suggest doing a lot of research and or just taking it to a professional cage guy. That's probably your best bet. But other than that, that's going to do it for this one. For the last episode, I think we'll do three of these. The last one will be getting the down bars installed, getting the cage painted, and making some caps for the outriggers. And that should tie up the whole cage installation series. But remember to like, comment, and subscribe. It's really helping the videos out, so keep it up. And we'll see you guys in the next one. All right, dude. Tell them see you later. We'll see you in the next one.